Doing the live stream. I think it's running now. Woo! All right. Cool. I think we're live. Yay! Hello, everyone. Miss Art here to give you this 14th edition of Miss Art Monday, the live stream in which, I don't know, we talk to each other. I give you an update about my life and what's going on and all things. And then we have a Q&A session. So yes, these are usually two-parters, a two-parter live stream. Yeah. I don't know about you guys, but I am totally sliding into that Thanksgiving lull or vacation mode. Man, as of the moment I woke up this morning, I was just like, ah, vacation mode. This is a 3-day work week for a lot of us here in America because the American Thanksgiving is on Thursday, this Thursday. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. I'm a big sucker when it comes to holidays. So, yeah, I'm just totally in chill mode. But a big shout out to everyone who can join us for this live stream in the live chat. Thank you for being here live. And as always, a big thank you to everyone who can watch this and join in the conversation after the fact. So I see several of you here already. Shout out to Flames. Well, I hope Flames, you say you've never got to see the live stream. I hope this is the day you can see it live. And I see Kamujin. Yes, you did arrive early. Sailor Stuff. Jeff E is back. Welcome back, Jeff E. Carmine, hello. Ninjavi is back again. Hello, hello. So yeah, I guess I'll just segue right into my usual weekly update. As we were talking about, Thanksgiving is on Thursday. Yeah, I'm just like so ready for the holiday season. I love the holidays. But Thanksgiving being this weekend, well, when Thanksgiving starts, I kind of just like turn it into a 4-day weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And because it's this week, there will be no second video from me on my channel because I'm going to be with my family. I'm going to be out of town, and my mind is going to be squarely focused on eating too much. And then repeating, and then sleeping, and then repeating. So I'm pretty much just gonna be out of it, and a happy days of eating too much food. So yeah, it'll be exciting. I hope you guys, if you celebrate Thanksgiving, that you guys have an excellent holiday as well. And I wonder if anybody's into Black Friday. I have yet to experience Black Friday, which I think, is this a phenomenon for the States? I don't know if it happens outside of America, but the day after Thanksgiving, that Friday, Black Friday, is like the number one shopping day, and like stores do these crazy deals, and people make it a family event, and they like stay in line at like 1 a.m. at Walmart because they want to get all the crazy deals. I don't know. It's just mass chaos. It looks like absolutely zero fun. So I'm curious if anybody here is going to do Black Friday. I don't know. I might do Cyber Monday because now we have more days. It's Black Friday, Small Business Saturday, which go support your local small business on Small Business Saturday, and then Cyber Monday. I think I might do stuff for Cyber Monday because there's usually good deals. Yeah, I'm just thinking of that food, man. Thinking of that Thanksgiving food. I love the turkey. I love the ham. I think we talked about this in the episode from last week, the last Miss Art Monday, about how much ham, holiday ham, and holiday turkey is so delicious. But yes, Jeffy, I see you say you love stuffing. I agree. I love stuffing as well. I used to not like stuffing, but now I love it. I still don't like cranberry sauce. There's all these traditional dishes that go with the American Thanksgiving. Your turkey, your ham, your stuffing, your cranberry sauce crap, green bean casserole, sweet potato, something that has like marshmallows. I'm not big on sweet potatoes, but that's another traditional dish. Usually some kind of corn dish, cream of corn. Oh, hi, Markle. Come say hi. You kitty. Markle, come here. Ugh. Get over here. Marco comes and says hello. Woo. Don't hit the mic, Marco. There you go. There you go. Sit down. Sit down. There you go. Camera's that way, buddy. Anyway, so yeah, really excited for all that delicious food. And here's a cat. Marco says hello. Let's see. Oh, I know something I am going to be buying for Black Friday. And that is my badge for Anime Expo next year in Los Angeles. I've already been planning this out. The last 2 years, I purchased my badge on their Black Friday sale thing. I think they're stretching it out for like the entire weekend this year. But it's a great way to get your badge and save money. Because I think it's going to be like $60 or $65 or something. It's going to be a cheaper price. So, huh, Marco? And that means I also have to start planning for a hotel room. Oh, Marco. I already got a place picked out, and it's not a hotel. I don't want to give too much away because, like, I've been, like, staring at this place for the past 2 weeks and hoping nobody books it. But we'll see. I got to get all my plans together because it'll require coordination with other people. So, yeah, Anime Expo. I can't wait. Even though it's going to be July of next year, I already cannot wait. Okay, here you go. He got his licks. He's got his loves. He's good. Let's see. As far as anime is concerned, definitely check out the latest Spoiler Alert podcast because I am the special guest on this most recent episode. So you'll notice in the description box of this live stream, I have put a link to it. So if you want to hear us discussing, this is me as the guest. This is my lovely friend Sheena and her boyfriend Ray. Excuse me. And we discuss the latest episodes of One Punch Man, Noragami, Ushio Totora. Oh, what else did we do? Oh, Lovely Bones. So we discussed the latest episodes of those four anime. So if you want to hear our thoughts, please check out that link and give that video a thumbs up. It was a lot of fun to do that podcast. It was actually my very first podcast. So yeah, a lot of fun overall. Go check it out. Go support their channel and that episode. Let's see, as far as books, let me see. Okay, I finished the other book I was reading, the Brandon Sanderson book. Shadows of Self. So I wrapped that up. I enjoyed it. Lots of twists at the end, as always. Darn it. It was very dramatic. But now I have moved on to The Glass Sword by Victoria Aveyard. This is the second book in, I don't know if the series has a name, but it's the sequel to Red Queen, which got pretty popular in the young adult fantasy genre. So this is an early copy of the second book. I think it's being released February of next year, 2016. So I've had this galley like sitting around the last month, just like getting around to it now. So I'm on chapter two. I'm not that far, but I feel like I'm remembering better than I thought I would what happened in the first book. Because it has been like a year since I read the first book. But yeah, I think that's it. Again, I'm just like on turkey mode. It's been so hard to like focus on my work. And I'm not putting pressure on myself to just focus on your work. Because the holidays are only once a year. And I am working throughout the day. It's just I'm allowing myself to feel relaxed, to not stress out, and yeah, just really focus on learning how to work in like smaller increments. So like, here's 3 hours, get as much done as you can in those 3 hours, and then chill out for the rest of the day. You know, work on your social media and stuff for my business, but then just like, don't get mad at yourself. I think we beat ourselves up too much. And I am definitely one of those people who's just like always riding herd on myself to like get stuff done. But then you get stressed down. Where's the fun in that? Life's too short to be stressed out. Get your work done, but then know how to have fun too. So yeah, turkey, I'm ready. But now I will transition over to the Q&A part of this live stream. So please leave your questions in the live chat, and I'm going to go through them and answer them. And once again, I apologize if I miss your question. I feel like I do this every stream. I'm really trying to improve on it. But yeah, bear with me. Thank you for all your questions. And now I'm going to jump right in. Let's see here. Let's see here. Oh, I Will One is here again. Hello again. I love how every time you enter into the live chat, I Will One, it's always with the phrase, it's over 9,000. Very choice. Very choice. Kamujin 6 says, I would do Black Friday, but I don't want to die. I know. It looks so terrifying. Like, YouTube those videos of, like, the worst, like, stampedes that have occurred on Black Friday. Someone always usually dies every Black Friday from getting stomped on. Because everyone just, like, rushes through the doors of, like, the really big, what do you call those? Really big box stores. So, like, your Walmarts and your Targets and all that kind of stuff. So, oh, just terrifying. I'm glad I'm not the only one that is terrified of that. I Will One says, he also loves stuffing. I know, I'm so glad I came around to stuffing. I don't know what was wrong with me when I was younger. I just didn't like stuffing. Now it's like the thing I eat too much of Thanksgiving, but no shame. Yeah, the one thing that bugs me is like people who are trying to be calorie conscious on Thanksgiving, because that's completely opposite of the point. Now, I understand if you worked really hard to lose weight and you know you will be tempted to overeat and you just don't want to go down that path again. That's cool. I totally understand with wanting like low calorie. But there's all these like poser people who are like, oh, I can't eat all this. And they just complain about it. It's like, no, just accept the fact. Just accept the glory that is the Thanksgiving meal. Just embrace it. I'm totally embracing it. I'm probably going to gain like at least 5 pounds over this holiday season, because Christmas is another like really big celebratory eating thing, excuse to eat pretty much. So between Thanksgiving and Christmas, I'm just, yeah, I'm expecting to put on 5 pounds with no shame. I'll just have to work them off later. That's what New Year's resolutions are for, right? Right. Mm-hmm. Do-do-do. Hylian Dulis is here too. Hello, Hylian. Thanks for joining us again. Yes, my cat did make a cameo. Carmine, I'm just looking at your comment. Wild Neko appears. It's true. Every once in a while, my cats will show up for a live stream or a video. All right, here we go. But Popo, he hasn't lately, but he's been napping at this time of day. He's currently napping in one of his favorite places. So I doubt we'll get an appearance from him during the stream. Unfortunately, Kamujin, you want to go to Anime Expo. It's like the best. I love Anime Expo. I mean, it's gotten a little more corporate just because it is the main trade show in North America for everything anime. So you know Viz, you know Funimation, you know Shonen Jump. Like, doesn't Viz own Shonen Jump? Anyway, they're all massively involved. Crunchyroll, all massively involved in this expo. But that kind of makes it fun too, because they can bring in the big guests. Yeah, love it. And it keeps getting bigger each year. I think I started going to Anime Expo in 2012. So I've gone 12, 13, 14, 15. So I've gone 4 years in a row, which I know there's people who have gone way more than I have. I'm still a rookie compared to so many other weebs out there. But just from going like those 4 years, I've definitely seen it grow. And they're figuring things out too. I really love the badge process because before it was badge con where you like waited 4 hours to get your badge. But this year it was just like seconds. It was so easy. It's oh, it's amazing. Do this from now on. So I hope everyone can get to Anime Expo at some point. It is the best pilgrimage you can make for as being a weeb, you know. If you can get down here to the West Coast, do it. You will not be disappointed. And it's great because you'll find that there are a lot of people in like the anime community who go that you'll get a chance to meet and talk with. So, I mean, this year it was great. I got to meet up and talk with so many fellow YouTubers and people in the anime community. It's just so fun. So everyone go if you can. Javier says, "Oh my gosh, my cat looks just like yours." Well, I do love orange kitties. Was technically called. Oh, I know this. Orange tabby. That's the type of cat Marco is. So, Garfield cat. Yay. I have actually kind of like an inside joke with another one of my friends. She lives in Long Beach, but she also has an orange tabby cat. And his name is Fred, like Fred Weasley. And we have this thing where we keep Snapchatting each other pictures or videos of our orange tabbies doing something. They do something funny. This has been going on for like most of this year. It's just like, hey, look, Marco did this thing. Like, oh, look at Fred. He's loafing on the floor. I don't know. Maybe that's only amusing to me and my friend. But it's like, yeah, orange tabbies, they are the best. Kamujin asks, Miss Art, have you played any Persona games? I don't think I have. No, I've not played any. I've heard of them, but I honestly don't know much about them. So any enlightenment would be most appreciated. Ninjavi says, Miss Art, I thought you were going to pair yourself with Madara in the last video. In reference to my most recent video about my top five Naruto pairings, both fan pairings and canon pairings. I know, that's like the ultimate pairing, I suppose, is me with Madara. But I was trying to stick with character to character. So, in my heart, he's my husbando, so number one pairing. But aside from just being character to character, then it's got to be Hashimoto. I'm sorry, it's just way too amusing to not love. Hylian asks, Miss Art, have you watched Gash Bell slash Zash Bell? I have no idea what that is, Hylian. Gash Bell slash Zach. No, Zach is with a K. Zash Bell. I don't know what that is. Tell me what it is, Hylian. Where was I? I keep losing my spot. Kamuchin says, I finally watched Shogeki no Soma. I need a season two, right? Right? Shogeki no Soma was so good. I think the ending for this first season was a little corny and a little fast, but I'm totally ready for season two. Please be soon. I have a feeling, I haven't read any facts yet, but I get the feeling it could be as soon as spring, maybe. Worst case, I don't know. Fall? God, I hope they don't wait till fall. I'm hoping it's spring we get season two. Don't make us wait. Oh, if you really want to buy the manga, who is it? Right Stuff. Right Stuff with one F.com has been having these crazy amazing sales for both manga and anime. And one of their big sales is a bundling of all, I think it's all that is currently printed Shokugeki no Soma manga. And it's like 40% off. It's an amazing deal. They also have this for Assassination Classroom. She's like, oh, I want to buy all these for myself. If you want to, you can, because it's on rightstuff.com. I love that site. It's been getting better and better, too. Like, it used to be, like, small and kind of old school, but now it's, like, all up to date, and they have a huge inventory, and just the great sales continue on. Love it. I Will One, Glass Sword, huh? I'll wait for the movie. Yeah, I wonder. I mean, a lot of books tend to be auctioned for movies. Doesn't mean they're going to be made for a movie. And I think this series has been auctioned for a movie, but that usually doesn't mean anything for a lot of things. Movie studios just like to buy books that are popular, their stories up, the rights to make a movie for that story up, and then they like put it in a little inventory that they'd kind of put to the side so that they can say that they own it, whether they're going to act on it or not. It's just the fact that they own the rights makes them feel real good. Then they can continue to test the waters. So we'll see. I'm pretty sure this has been auctioned and bought. I think it would make an okay movie. I think it'd be cool. We'll see. I always like to support YA fantasy movies or dystopians. Speaking of which, I saw Mockingjay Part 2 yesterday, and it was pretty much as dark and depressing as I remember the third book being. So it all works together. Though the movie did make the ending a little cheerier, because I remember it wasn't really like ultimately a cheery outcome for Katniss. I mean, she just went through like 2 Hunger Games and then storming the Capitol. It was like, that does something to you mentally. You have PTSD, and it's, at least in the book, it was really about her getting through or living through her PTSD when there really, like, is no treatment in this dystopian world or recognition of this kind of this mental illness. So, oh well, I still enjoyed it. It was fun. It was fun to just get out there and support YA movies. Kamujin. I like how Shokugeki no Soma, the food is good. It's so good that they always rip off their clothes. Oh, that's so amazing about it. Well, what I recently learned, I think from Ray at Spoiler Alert Podcast, is that the author, the mangaka of the manga, used to do hentai. So he's really good at fan service and sexy shots, and but also like really well rendered images, such as with the food, which is always delicious looking. So with that in mind, that he used to write hentai, it makes perfect sense that everyone's clothes flies off when they're eating an amazing dish. I just love the comedy of it. So good. Jeffy says, I finished Game of Thrones season 1, and oh boy, everyone got screwed over. No survivors. So sad. Hey, there are survivors. That's why we're going to have a season 6. Is it season 6 that's coming next year? They just were putting out the promos for it today. Maybe it's season 7. I don't even know where we're at. But yeah, Game of Thrones. This is what it does. It finds your heart, and then it grabs it and just rips it out of your body and throws it on the ground and stomps on it over and over again. The end. That is Game of Thrones. But you'll love it. It's so good. You'll love that your heart gets smashed on the floor. I'm looking forward to the next season. B, Because the promo image they chose for the newest season coming out in April is of a character that supposedly gets stabbed, gets killed in the last season. Not saying who that character is or anything, but it's creating a lot of buzz, a lot of buzz in the fandom. So we'll see. We'll see. But it is a good series. If you guys like epic fantasies and world building and you like serious shows, then totally recommend Game of Thrones. Just prepare to get your heart ripped out several times and thrown on the floor and stomped on. Blue Variants is here. Hello, Blue Variants. Thank you for joining us today. Kamujin says, Miss Art, I have another North Dakota complaint. They teach only North Dakota history for most of the elementary years. They are going to make my sister stupid. Aw, man, that's strange. I wonder what they're going to focus on. I mean, I don't clearly remember what I was taught in elementary school, but from like preschool to fourth grade, I went to a Montessori school, which is kind of like an alternative school where it's kind of liberal, I suppose. I don't know. It was just school for me for the longest time. So they like to stay like very, they have like no agenda to like teach you or try to brainwash you in some way. So I think we got a pretty even keel when it came to history and world history and US history and state history. But I clearly do not remember focusing solely, in my case, on Arizona history. I'm just trying to think what they would focus on North Dakota. I mean, I would hope they would dedicate time to explain the tension that was between the Native American population and the European settlers and all those awful clashes that happened in the area. Not a very happy part of the history. I don't know. Sounds like too much brainwashing for me. I thought it was so crazy coming out of like a kind of like liberal, independent-minded school to the public system, public school system in the United States, at least here in Arizona. It was like it was kind of strange. The one thing that really like threw me for a loop is that in public school in the United States, every day you stand up, you face the American flag, you put your hand on your heart, and you say the Pledge of Allegiance, which for me, even fifth grader me was just like, oh, Nazis or something. It's totally not that, but it's still totally like a type of brainwashing. So I remember the first day of fifth grade, my first day in public school. I was just like, what is everyone doing? This is so strange. Everyone's chanting together. I just kind of like played along because I didn't know the Pledge of Allegiance. That's not something we did in Montessori school. Probably because it was too much like brainwashing. But you know, you just kind of get with the program. That's how I learned it, is just like hearing it every day in public school. Ooh. Kind of creepy. But whatever. So yeah, I'll be curious to see what exactly they teach your sister, Kamujin. I hope it is not brainwashing. Carmine says, what do you think of Usui Takumi and Misaki Ayuzawa? I'm not sure if I know those folks. Tell me who they are, then I can give you an opinion or not. Ushiromiya Badler says, Black Friday, only selling Naruto things, just saying worth it. Yeah, you know, if it was all Naruto or weeb related crap, I would be brave enough to go into Black Friday crowds. If there was a store that was like right stuff and it was just all weeb trash, I would be tempted to go in for those sales. Oh, it would be so amazing. But like TVs and just like electronic crap I don't really need. It's not worth it. It's not worth getting killed over, guys. Oh, favorite Shokugeki no Soma character. Good question. Well, I really like Soma, the main character. He is pretty cool. And I love his dad. I feel like his dad is my favorite character, actually. You know, anime dads are always so cool, especially in shonen stories. Kita asks, Saitama versus Goku. Ooh. Ooh. I know a lot of people have been posing this question. Man, that's a tough one. Because if Saitama can get close to Goku, if he can touch Goku and land a punch, Goku's dead. So far, Saitama's punch is infallible. But could Goku get away? Ding! Or Super Saiyan push Saitama back? He has that ability to keep a distance between him and Saitama. So I don't know. It would just depend. Can Saitama get close? But I think you could argue that Goku could keep Saitama away in some ways. I don't know. I guess Goku in that respect. But I can't see Saitama and Goku like going off on each other because they're very similar. I think they would get along actually. Let's see. Sailor Steph asks, Miss Art, have you watched when Marnie was there? If not, I recommend you watch it. It is so full of feels and made me wonder what the hell was going on for most of the film, and the ending made me cry. When Marnie was there. I don't know if I've seen that. Let me Google it. Burp, 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 burp. Excuse me. No, I haven't seen this one yet. I recognize the pictures. I was going to say it's Studio Ghibli or Ghibli, however you want to pronounce it. But I haven't seen it yet. But Ghibli films have a thing for making me cry. They're just so good at it. So I have little doubt that I will cry if you cried. Thank you for the recommendation. I'm going to keep this search tab up. In case I need to cry, I will seek that movie out. I see Mo Sherpner. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. With the question of working. Yes, it is working. If you're questioning if you're able to use the live chat, it does appear to be working for you. So congratulations, yay. Again, to those who are having trouble with the live chat, I still think it might be what device you are using, based on what device you are using. Because I don't think you can access the live chat of a live stream on YouTube through a mobile device. This would include an iPad or some kind of mobile tablet. And this would include a cell phone of any kind. So I think you have to be on a desktop in order to enjoy the live chat. That's just my assumption. I've tried to do research, and I know some people are still struggling. But I think that's the one thing I can latch on to that is true, is that you have to be on a desktop in order to participate in the live chat. For better or worse, I'm sure they're going to update that soon. Or I might be wrong. If I'm wrong, please let me know. Let's see. Carmine asks, what is your favorite starter Pokemon? I've always loved dragons. So I've always loved Charmander. Even when I was in, what was I, like fifth or sixth grade? I think it was in fifth or sixth grade when like Pokemon first hit the States. We first had trading cards. Man, I was just in love with Charmander. Because he looks like a dragon and he has fire on him. So, Charmander and Pikachu. I love Pikachu. Squirtle. So cute. I just love Pokemon. But I'd say my favorite starter was definitely Charmander. Oh, where was I in the live stream? Okay, here I am. Aw, I well once says I also had an orange cat and he ran away because of mom. They didn't get along. Oh, that sucks. That is sucks. I hate when there's strife in a family and it results in the pets departing. 'Cause I love the kitties. I hate when kitties go away. Oh, speaking of cats potentially going away. It's kind of a sad thing, but I don't feel too sad. This is okay. So I have a family cat. I grew up with this cat. This cat is now 21 years old. 21 years old. And yesterday, he wasn't looking too good. I was over at my parents' yesterday, and he wasn't looking too good. He's like losing control of his bowels. That's never a good sign. One thing I learned though is never try to predict death, especially in like someone who's old or an old animal. You just never know what's going to happen. He's still okay. I think he's recovered. But his time might be approaching soon. But again, as I mentioned, I can't feel too sad because he's 21 years old. He's such an old fart cat. I'm more impressed than anything. I'll miss him when he's gone, but I'm just like, wow. Good job. Good job, Sam. You're doing a great job. You can go out proud that you are older than a lot of humans, I know. I guess that's sad. I'll be sad when he goes. Yeah, I'm just like, man, I think I've only met one other cat that was older. I met one cat that was 23 years old. So yeah, that's personally that's the record. But most cats, they usually go anywhere between like 13 and like 17 is usually when a cat will go. I'm just like, yeah, Sam's 21. Go, Sam. Oh, okay. Hylan is saying that Gash Bell slash Dash Bell is an anime. Fascinating. I have not heard of it, which is not unusual. They were like a bajillion anime. Thank goodness we will never be bored. Let me put that in the old Google. Is this? Oh, wait. This looks familiar. I feel like I've seen this somewhere. Let me look at these pictures. I've seen some of these characters. Yes, I recognize the blonde-haired kid. But I don't know anything about the series, but I do recognize the blonde-haired character. Fascinating. Oh, gonna keep that tab up and look at it a little more later. Kamujin says you need to play Life is Strange, you'll fall in love with Chloe. I will put that on the board. I don't know whenever I'm gonna play Life is Strange. I'm curious who Chloe is. Let's Google it again. Google, you are our friend, Chloe. Excuse me. Man, I'm all full of burps. Oh, she looks pretty cool. I dig her blue hair. She looks like a badass. And I always appreciate a female badass. Carmen asks, Miss Art, are you watching Supergirl, The Flash, and Blind Spot, which are TV series? If yes, what do you think of them? I am not watching Flash, and I'm not watching Blind Spot, but I have caught a few episodes of Supergirl, and I've pretty much enjoyed what I've seen so far. It's not my favorite series, but I like that we're focusing on a strong female character. And we're getting that from a lot of other series, like Jessica Jones that just hit Netflix. I feel like there's another one somewhere. Anyway, so I don't know. I've just been lately kind of bad with keeping up with like the Marvel or any kind of superhero series, just because so many are coming out that it's getting difficult to keep up with them all. I think we're still about halfway through Daredevil. We still need to finish Daredevil, and I still haven't seen the second season of Shield. Now there's Supergirl, and now there's Jessica Jones I need to catch, and The Flash. I'm just like, oh, I don't have time for all these series. But let me know if you're enjoying them, because when they hit Netflix, they'll definitely get on my queue. It's just a matter of time that I'll eventually watch them. Jeff E asks, Miss Art, have you heard of The Isolator by Reki Kawahara, the creator of Sword Art Online and Excel World? It is a really good book. No, I haven't. I feel like I've heard of it, but I haven't read the book. In fact, I haven't read the Sword Art Online book either. I have a friend who's all caught up on all of Kawahara's works. So I kind of like lean on them for that information. But I mean, if it's as good as SAO, the book, I'm sure the Isolator will be good too. Is it also like in the gaming world? Curious to know. Do. Let's see. Moshpinder. Again, I apologize for most likely butchering your name. Miss Art, you talk a lot about Madara. And about the Sharingan. But I didn't see you talking about my favorite part in Naruto, and it is the Will of Fire. The Will of Fire is very critical to the Naruto series. I feel like I have had discussions on the Will of Fire, but they have been included in some of my chapter reviews, especially towards the end and in areas of the story where that really comes up. I've had some good in-depth discussions of the Will of Fire. Just lately in my other videos, the topic hasn't come up as much, even though it is an element that has unified many of the main characters, many of the heroes of the Naruto world. Yeah, it's important. Will of Fire is important. It's like the force. Okay, no, it's not the force. But no, I can probably. Oh, I see you have a second part to your question. What is the Will of Fire for you? I suppose if I wanted to touch into it, I feel like I've said it way better in other videos, but the Will of Fire for me represents everything that a hero in the Naruto world should possess. All the qualities they need to possess. Loyalty, dedication for yourself, but for your shinobi family. Just like Hashirama said, is that the true bearer of the Will of Fire is someone who can protect the family that is the village. Everyone in your village is a part of your family. So you have to think of the big picture like that. And so, yeah, selflessness, the ability to sacrifice yourself for the greater good, just to always think of what choice is going to benefit the most people, what is going to be the most positive, impactful choice I can make. So for me, that's kind of what the Will of Fire symbolizes, and that makes sense as to why it is a thread that connects many of the heroes in the Naruto world. So I guess that's kind of like a brief my brief explanation of how I interpret the Will of Fire. Kamujin 6 says, I am writing a story and I'm wondering if a magic system similar to Naruto's would work for this particular medium. Totally can. In my experience, magic will translate well through all the mediums. I can only think of one example where a magic system that's in a book may not translate as successfully to a visual medium. But for the most part, you can get away with more in books. You can elaborate and make more tangible a magic system in a book because you don't have those limitations of what we can create visually. So my example I was bringing up where something that works really well in a book that wouldn't work so well visually is the magic system in Mistborn. Because a lot of descriptions we get to how the magic is working is from an internal perspective. You burn metal, and a character is like, oh, turns on metal, bounces from this to that. where when you're reading it, you totally understand the processes that are going on. Have that internal dialogue of what the magician is thinking. But in a visual movie or an animation, it would be so tedious to have that dialogue going, oh, now I'm turning on this so I can do this. Just doesn't work as well. It would just look like a character is bouncing around in the air. And you're like, I've seen that before. That doesn't look that impressive. So you can get away with anything in writing. Picking magic systems that are closely tied to elements is a very popular motif. You cannot go wrong with that. I mean, another popular example is Avatar: The Last Airbender. Uses elements in a different way. There's so many magic systems that are based on the elements that you can, it's rich territory. You can go in, you can tweak it, and you can make it your own, and it'll work perfect for a book. So don't you worry about it. Mosh Pner, again, I butcher your name, I'm sorry. Says finally I can write comments. I'm so excited. I am so excited for you as well. That's at least one person who who has solved the problem in being able to participate in the live chat. I Will One says, can you sing it all now, Miss Art? Not many adults know the national anthem. I was talking about the Pledge of Allegiance. I hope I didn't say national anthem. But the Pledge of Allegiance, let's see if I can still remember it. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. That's what we had to repeat every single day in public school, on up into high school, as an 18-year-old. Oh man. Again, it sounds like brainwashing. But yeah, so that's the national anthem. All public school children have to recite. I'm proud of myself. I think I still know the preamble too. I think I do. I'm trying to remember it now. We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this constitution for the United States of America. Bam! I still remember that. Brainwashing. Just kidding. And I know the national anthem too. I'm not gonna torture your ears with my singing, but I do know the national anthem word by word. So I guess I'm a good American. If that's what makes a good American. What even is that? Do-do-do. Kamujin. North Dakota likes to brainwash people into staying here. They don't want people to know that the about the amazingness of the outside world. You should hear what people say about Japan here. Oh, I can only imagine. Well, I don't necessarily blame North Dakota because when I think of the Dakotas, no offense to anybody who lives there and loves it, but it doesn't seem like the most exciting place. In fact, there is a hilarious commercial that came out. I think it was South Dakota that was trying to like attract people to move to South Dakota. And it was like, you could go to Mars and potentially die, or you can move to South Dakota where you won't die. It's just as good as Mars. It was like, I don't think that came out the way you meant it to. It's so good. It got made fun of in a lot of shows in the US. Because it's like, okay, that still doesn't make me want to move there. I didn't want to move to Mars either. Pretty silly. Carmine says, Usui and Misaki are from Kaito wa Maid-sama. I have not seen that series or read it, so I'm sorry I don't have opinions on those characters. Oh, I'm just stoop, hello stoop. I'm just reading your comment, which is, what's my opinion on Forever Worlds? I'm assuming that's Forever Worlds, even though you say Forever Wizzy's hip hop new love song for the kiddos. I have not seen it yet, so if he made a song, I have no opinion of it. But I mean, Forever World is one of my compatriots of the weeb community, the reviewer community. So, you know, I like to see people doing creative things. Hello. Jeffy says, the only live chat I wasn't able to send a message was yours. Very strange. Again, I know the comments are disabled and I don't have control of that, but I think it's a YouTube problem because I don't do anything weird or different than anybody else. So, I don't know, maybe YouTube doesn't like me. Oh, the cats are inside. my husband went outside to call the cats. But both cats are inside. Oops. Sailor Steph asks, what do you think of shows bringing in characters just to be a love interest of the main character and them having no character development other than that purpose for the show? Well, that's lame. I'm tired of that stupid excuse for character development. Oh, I'm legitimized because I'm the love interest. Either way, whether that's a love interest for a male character or a female character, it's like, why even have the character? These are supposed to mimic people. People aren't just that one-dimensional, no matter what. So it's always lame. It's always lame. Aw, Kamujin says this kitty has seizures. That would be scary. I've not had an animal that we had to, like, give seizure medicine to and stuff, but that would freak me out. Let's see. Kamujin says, have you looked up Kamigami no Asobi? Have I looked that up? I feel like I only have like 5 brain cells today. Let me double check. Yes, I have looked that up. Fear not. I have looked it up. Oh, Carmine says, how about the new anime / film Digimon Tri Adventure? I have yet to see that. It's on my to-do list. That's just like another one of those shows that brings back all the childhood feels. I need to get on that. Everyone else is talking about it. And yes, that ties into Sailor Steph's question as well. Am I going to watch it? Yes. I'm going to watch it. Hopefully this week sometime. But just preparing my heart for all the feels. Sailor Steph, Sonic or Mario? Oh, that's tough. I think I'll go with Sonic, just because he's more rambunctious as a character. Hylian Doulas, I've run out of things to ask. That's okay, Hylian. You've been doing a good job this stream asking questions. Don't put pressure on yourself. You can always sit back and enjoy. Kamujin6 asks, have you played the Naruto games for PS2? No, I started playing the Naruto games on PS3, so I haven't played the older ones. Hylian Doulas, see, you came up with another question. When you consider doing a gaming channel? I don't think I game consistently enough to support a channel that can be all out on its own some. If I gamed more frequently, then I can see myself doing that. Right now, if I'm going to record myself gaming, I'll probably just put it on this channel because it'd be like a twice a year, 3 times a year thing, if that. But I have a lot of friends in the YouTube community who do game enough to have their own gaming channel, which is good for them. I just don't make the time to do it. Ooh, Carmine poses a tricky question. Chakra versus Nin versus magic. What do you choose? Technically, the way chakra and Nin are described, they can be categorized as a type of magic. So I don't know if you can pit them against magic itself. I think you could pit them against chakra against Nin. I love all magic. So I love chakra and I love Nin. Oh, it's tough to choose though. They're both so good and they both have such good philosophies behind them. I guess I'll go with chakra just because I've been a Naruto fan longer than I've been a Hunter x Hunter fan. But both are great. Both are great magic systems. I'm just reading your guys' comments about Digimon. Since the topic is up, I may not be responding to them, but I am reading through them. Digimon. Mosh. May I just call you Mosh? I'll call you Mosh. Which fight did I most enjoy in Naruto? You can include the manga in my calculations. Whoa. There are lots of wonderful fights. I think I did a video, top 5 fights in Naruto that I enjoyed most. And I can't remember what I put as my number one. Well, I know one of my top ones is actually Naruto versus Pain, because that was the first major battle that Kishimoto built up. He built up the main villain. He built up Naruto with new powers. That was the first big OP clash that Kishimoto gave us. And for that, I respect it and I enjoyed it. Whether or not you like the outcome or not, you still gotta respect that this was the first major battle for Naruto being one-on-one with the main villain. So, and another favorite, gotta go classic, Zabuza and Haku versus Team 7, the very first battle that Team 7 has. Oh, it's just so full of feels. It touches on all the emotional points a good battle should have. Still holds up as one of the best battles for me throughout the series. So yeah, first things that come to mind are at least those two battles. They're very good. The battles towards the end of the series, I feel like got kind of OP and a little tedious. but of course I still enjoyed them as a Naruto fan. But still, those two remain strong in my mind. That's a good question, Kamujin. If I could have one of the paths of pain powers, what would it be? Which one would I choose? You would choose Tendo. Oh, man. I like the one that summons all of the beasts, but I forget what it's called. Gasp. Let me check it out. I mean, Tendo is popular because, kind of like the face of pain. When we think pain, we're actually thinking of the Tendo path. But I really like the chick who does the summonings. Even though she doesn't play that big a role, just the summonings she comes out with are just crazy. Crazy. Yeah, the Deva path. Mm-hmm. That's a good one, too. That was one of the things I enjoyed most about Pain's power, is that we figured out eventually that it's separated into these 6 different powers. Oh, I just love the mystery behind pain. That was a really cool part in the series when we just had no idea what was going on. Jeffy, I'm just reading your Synopsis of The Isolator. Interesting. You take a walk? Okay. Enjoy your walk. Oh, and kitties are inside. You know. I tried to call out to you. I was like, no, they're inside. Do, do, do. Wah! Auto refresh, drive me nuts. Carmine asks, what do you think of Nisei Koi? I don't think I've read that manga. Let me check it out. Google. No, I have not read this or seen this. Looks interesting. Well, if you loved it, let me know what you most enjoyed about it, Carmine. And if you would totally recommend it for me to watch. Because I will add it to my master list of recommendations you guys give me. Which I love so dearly. Because I know I'm never going to be bored. You guys always have such great ones. Oh, Sailor Steph asks, have you read Oran High School Host Club and Fruits Basket, the manga? They have so much that the anime didn't show. It is true, I have read both of those. And yes, tons of feels. For me, these are kind of classic manga because they came out, I think when I was in high school? I don't know, it's been a while since they've been out. And I remember reading them when they first came out, which yeah, was probably almost 8-10 years ago at this point. So yeah, those are both great manga. I feel like I did still cry a lot at the end of the Fruits Basket anime, though. I do remember sobbing. Kamujin 6. Undertaker is one of my all-time favorite anime guys. Miss Art, gaze at his beautiful green eyes. All right, let me gaze upon those. A quick Google search. I don't know if you're talking about anime or like The Undertaker. Oh, from Black Butler. Let me know if that's who you're referencing. Oh, I need to watch Black Butler. That's one of those manga that, anime too. That I know I'll like, and I can't believe I haven't gotten to. Shake my head, shake my head. Hylian Doolis, good question. What manga are you going to review next? I kind of want to do a One Punch Man review because, well, the manga is amazing, and there's a lot of hype for One Punch Man right now, so I can really tap into that. When I would get around to that, I have no idea, but I've kind of had that in the back of my mind of, I should do a review for One Punch Man manga. Ninjabi says, or asks, have you ever played any of the Soul Calibur games? If you have, which is your favorite game and character? I have not played any of the Soul Calibur games. Though I have friends who have, and I don't think I have a favorite character though, just because I haven't personally played the game. But I can Google it, because I can usually tell what character is going to be my favorite, like, immediately. Let's see here. Oh, there's a lot of badass characters. I like the Athena chick. She looks pretty cool. She's got the shield. Oh, come on. Render already so I can stare at the character. Red hair chick with armor looks pretty badass. Yeah, cool character designs. But no, I haven't played this game personally. Sad face. Yellow Flashin. Which one is your favorite Naruto volume cover? Oh, that's such a tough question because there's 5 million of them. Ooh, What are some of my favorite ones? Gosh, I don't know if I can recall one. Well, I for a recent one, I really love the cover just because it spanned the generations of the Will of Fire and the generations more specifically of Indra and Ashida's reincarnations. And that was the cover that featured like Madara and Hashirama, and then we saw Indra and Ashura, and we saw we saw Naruto and Sasuke. And it was just there's something so poignant about that cover. So as far as a recent one, that's one of my favorites. But I love every cover that has Madara in it pretty much. And I love the cover also that was featured for when Sasuke versus Itachi was going on. That's a good cover too. There's a lot of covers. Oh man. Do you know there's like 72 volumes? I cannot recall all 72, but those at least are some of my favorites. Thank you for the question. That was an intriguing question. Kamujin 6, what would happen if Hisoka and Orochimaru fused into one person? How would they choose between Gon and Sasuke? They would go for both of them, obviously. Oh, that would just be too much creepy pedophilia for anyone to handle if those two characters merged together. Just be the intensity would be over 9,000. Too much. Thank goodness it won't happen, hopefully. Oops. Auto refresh. Darn it. Okay. And I should mention that we are about 8 minutes past the hour. I do like to keep these streams around an hour. I've been doing pretty bad at that the last couple weeks. We've gone about 20 minutes over. So I'm just going to put it in your head, guys, now that if you have any questions, please put them in the chat now because I'm going to be wrapping up here soon. Soon. Keyword. Devin Stanford asks, do you like Kaguya Otsutsuki? Otsutsuki, excuse me. At first, I was intrigued by Kaguya. I said, look, here is a female character who looks like she has an intriguing, like, history, backstory, there's the word I was going for, has potentially fascinating backstory, who's going to be super powerful and dimensional, and I can't wait for her to present her mystery and challenge. Only to be disappointed when she eventually became a major player, and she got none of that. She got like zero backstory. Her motives were so flat. Her character was so flat. Only thing that was like redeeming was that she had a somewhat interesting character design. But as a character, she's just what there's like not much there to like. You'd have to fill in the blanks. Again, kind of like Vin, Obito's love interest. It's a character you can take and put it in the fandom and like really round it out. Someone, and there are people out there in the fandom who've really rounded out Kaguya's character. She's so much more fascinating in that respect. But in the canon, she is just a flat character. And that is so sad. And I think it's one of the reasons why the battle, the struggle against her between the good guys, I think that's the reason that battle kind of sucked, is because I didn't care about the villain that much. We care about Madara because he got so much hype. We know so much about his history. He's integral, and we learn to appreciate how integral his role has been in shaping Shinobi history. So he's really the pinnacle for me of a bad guy that Kishimoto has written. But then Kaguya comes in and we could care less. She comes out of left field. And so it's so bad. I feel like if he had developed her a little more, I would have liked her more. But she's just not a well-developed character. It's so sad. Kaimujin 6. I hate the robot pain dude. He's way too creepy. Yeah, that is pretty strange when pain can just sprout out a robot arm. So strange. I feel like that anytime those kind of weird sci-fi elements popped up, like robots and laser beams from something that looks like advanced technology, anytime that like made an appearance in Naruto, which it rarely did, but it did sometimes, it just never made sense with the world. If I was Kishimoto's editor, I might have been like, maybe don't do that. But it makes sense. And if you remember that, he's a huge sci-fi fan, so I'm sure he would just try to sneak it in whenever he can. But now he's creating a series that's all sci-fi, so he's gonna be very happy about that. But yeah, robot pain dude or anything robot-y is always a little odd coming from the Naruto world. Ergo Vide Oasis asks, have you ever tried to make an AMV? Oh, I'm sure I have. If I did, I'm not sure where it is. I've always had a lot of ideas for AMVs too. I think maybe I've completed one, but again, that was a long time ago, and I have no idea where it is, and I'm not sure I would want it to see the light of day because I'd be too embarrassed. Ooh, Carmine asks, what? Oh, can't wait for the new episode of Sherlock on January 1st. Do you watch the series? I do watch the series. I'm a little behind. I think, how many seasons are there? Three seasons? I think I'm in the second season right now on Netflix. So yeah, I do like it. Modern, if we're talking about the right one with Cumberbatch, I do enjoy the modern twist on Sherlock because I think a couple of years ago I like went back and read all the Sherlock Holmes stories. So like I feel like I can super appreciate all these modern spins on Sherlock, and it's always a joy to see Cumberbatch. Who was texting me? All right. So yes, I am excited. I did hear about new Sherlock coming up. That'll be great. Do 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 do. Devin asks, "Who's Rinnegan do you like best in the series?" Good question. I mean, I like Madara, obviously, so I like his Rinnegan. But the one that kind of intrigues me the most, because it's the weirdest perhaps, is Sasuke's. Right now, his is the most intriguing because it's the newest and the way he got it. Some people don't like the way he got it. And yeah, some people just take issue with the fact that Sasuke even has the Rinnegan. I mean, everyone has their right to their opinion. But for me right now, it's the most intriguing Rinnegan. So it is my favorite. And it's just, I think the one that like appears on foreheads is just weird. It's kind of gross. Devin asks again. Excuse me. Who do you think is stronger? Hagoromo or the current Madara? I think Madara was the strongest because he basically knighted the two types of chakra that Hagoromo, the Sage of Six Paths, bequeathed to his sons, and then he took it to the next level. He became basically all, or he encompassed in himself all the power that made up the original Sage of Six Paths, but then he took it a step farther by then attaining power that the Sage of Six Paths' mother had, Kaguya had. So at that point, I believe he became more powerful than Hagoromo. Like physically powerful with like super moves and stuff. In terms of like different kinds of power, like influence, I think Hagoromo probably wins the battle of influence just because he's technically been around, at least in chakra form, for like most of shinobi history. Whereas Modernist had a lot of influence as well, but it's been modern history. So you can argue that kind of power as well. But in terms of like ultimate power, I think Madara pushed himself higher than Hagoromo. Carmine asks, what do I think about Pretty Little Liars? I haven't read the book series and I haven't watched the TV series, so I don't really have an opinion on it. Though I have a friend who loves it, who loved the series as a book and loved the TV series. So I don't know, I just haven't watched it or read it. I have no opinions. Kamujin, just reading your comment about the wrestler, Black Butler. Everyone is attracted to this character. Fascinating. Well, I think he looks very attractive. I was immediately intrigued. It just further encourages me to finally get on that series. Okay. Ergo asks, favorite stand-up comedian? Oh, goodness. Right now, I like Gaffigan. I love Louie. Louie's so funny. Jerry Seinfeld, of course, is classic. I like Amy Schumer. Who's that guy who like tells jokes, but then like he also does like music? He has like the synthesizer kind of thing. Oh, he's so good too. I forget his name though. Who else do I like? Oh, I like Chris Rock. I know those are all kind of like really mainstream comedians. I'm not cool enough to know all the like not mainstream comedians, stand-up comics. Cho, I forget her first name, but the lady whose last name is Cho, I think she's pretty funny too. I guess those are my top ones, or at least the ones that come to mind immediately. But yeah, definitely number one among those would probably be Louie, because Louie's so funny. His TV show's hilarious, equally hilarious. Kamujin, I agree, we need volumes dedicated to Kaguya's backstory, because then we would care. We just don't get it. It's so sad. I think she has potential, but I just hate her for what she did because she had no backstory. Ugh. Dirt, 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 dirt. Oops. Highly Duelist. Miss Art, we obviously want more Naruto filler. No, we don't. We don't want more Naruto filler. Unless maybe if it's about Kaguya. I could accept that maybe. I will one. Put in that overtime, Miss Art. Yeah, I guess you can consider this kind of overtime. I guess I just enjoy talking to you guys so much. Okay, Ninjavi, I did see a recommendation of which of the series to focus on. Not to bother with the fifth one. I will keep that in mind. Oh, Hylian. I just saw a vine where a cat fell off a 10-story building. Well, I will be happy to reassure you, Hylian, that that cat is probably fine. I heard this fascinating scientific article. I guess it was a study. Maybe it was from This American Life. It was on NPR or National Public Radio for any fellow American fans of that program, which observed the strange phenomenon of cats surviving falling off buildings. And the study showed that as long as a cat falls off of a window that I think is 8 or 9 stories or higher, the cat will be fine. He will survive. If it's like eight or nine stories and below, the cat will probably die. But because there's so much wind resistance in a window or a ledge that is about 10 stories or higher, cats will usually always survive. Even there are stories of cats falling off from the 50th story, and they survive because they pick up so much of that air resistance that they might as well have fallen off from 10 stories. So very, very strange. So don't feel too bad. I'm sure that cat was okay. But I would be absolutely horrified either way if I saw my cat or a cat fall off of a ledge that high. You're like, oh my God. But I feel better knowing that the cats usually survive. Devin, you like Sasuke's Rinnegan as well. I do like the whole time-space jutsu he gets with it. It's very intriguing. Okay, I think we'll start to wrap it up, guys. Gonna finish up reading these other comments you have posted. Oh, Sailor Steph talking about Once Upon a Time. Do I like Regina? I do like Regina. Because character development. A woman who is a villain, but she's likable because she gets character development. Man, wouldn't that be nice if, like, some character called Kaguya got that same treatment? But no, that's precisely why I like Regina, is because she is a complex character. We see things from her perspective, her choices. We understand them, and that's what makes the difference in building rapport between your characters and your audience. But yeah, the whole Robin Hood thing, I'm just gonna laugh. I think it's pretty silly too. Do 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 do. Awesome! I've made it to the end of the live chat comments. I always feel like I always barely get there, but I've managed to get there. So, all right, yep, officially caught up and read all of your comments. So without further ado, I'm going to officially wrap up this live stream. A big thank you for joining me. Sorry, Tokyo, SAO activates. I'm sorry, you're just now popping in. But hey, look at the bright side. At least you got to catch a little bit of it. And you got to comment live. So there's the positive spin. Wa-sha! But this always goes up on my channel after the fact. So if you want to start from the beginning, you certainly can. But thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone, for joining us. Oh, I should say, on the topic of Once Upon a Time, I do like Rumpelstiltskin a lot. Regina and Rumpelstiltskin, two of my favorite characters. Miss Art Senpai. Yeah, I'll give you a shout out, Tokyo. Don't you worry. And I will be back here next Monday. Again, no video at the end of this week because it is American Thanksgiving and I'm going to be eating and sleeping and eating and sleeping and eating and sleeping. So I'll be very, very occupied. But planning to be back here next Monday to live stream with you guys. So thank you again. I'm glad for all you guys subscribing and enjoying the stream and enjoying my videos. It does mean the world to me. It's something I'm thankful for every day. So thank you again. And yeah, have a great Thanksgiving if you celebrate. And I'll see you back here next week. Bye.